Good evening, Gym Rocks. Welcome to Royal Oasis Spa for You Educational Tidbits. My name is Zenobia, licensed esthetician in Maryland, D.C., and Virginia. For those who are new to my channel, thank you so much for stopping by today. Please view all of my other educational videos to learn more about Royal Oasis Spa for You. And don't forget to click that subscribe and notification button to be the first to receive notifications when new educational tidbit videos are uploaded. We want you to stay up to date, you know that, and we want you to stay connected with the latest content from your favorite creator. Say my name, Zenobia. I share my business with my husband, Corey, who is also a licensed esthetician, and Corey caters to the male clientele. Corey specializes in the beard treatments, the beard maintenance, and those males who are struggling with growing their mane. Now, when you book your appointment with Corey, ask him about the Nobleman Beard Balm and the Nobleman Beard Tonic, or just visit our website and place your order. Now, if you want to keep in touch and know what's happening in our world, engage with us in conversations, or just for entertainment, do a soft subscribe and follow me on all of my social media platforms, Facebook, TikTok, and Instagram, especially TikTok before they ban that. So, and if you're seeking more of a focal point of my business and you want to learn about my services and treatments that we provide, feel free to tour my website at royaloasisspa-gjc.com. Now, today we're going to do a mini learning session on a skin condition called acne. Now, at this point, I really want you to get your pen, your pencil, your notepad. I really want you to give me your listening ears because I'm going to drop a lot of gems. I'm giving out a lot of information today, and I want to give it to you the way I have studied it so I know that it's right. So what is acne? The medical term for acne is acne vulgaris, V-U-L-G-A-R-I-S. Vulgaris means common or normal. The alternative names for acne are cystic acne, pimples, or zits. So acne is a very common skin condition that occurs when hair follicles under the skin becomes plugged with oil and dead skin cells. Sebum is the oil that help keep skin from drying out, and dead skin cells plug the pores, which leads to outbreaks of lesions, commonly called pimples or zits. So most outbreaks occur on the face, but also it appears on the back, the chest, and the shoulders. The pore blockages causes or produce an open comedone. So we know open comedones, layman term is blackheads. And when we say closed comedones, the layman term is whiteheads or pimples. So when dead skin cells and oils collect in the opening to the skin follicle producing a bump, it is called comedone. So acne is most common among teens and also affect people of all ages. Acne is an inflammatory disorder of the skin. Acne is a disease in which has sebaceous glands that connects to the hair follicle, which contains a fine hair. Now, sebaceous gland is what I said, that's the oil where the sebum comes from. Now, in healthy skin, the sebaceous glands make sebum, but empties onto the skin surface through the pore, which is an opening in the follicle. Now, how does acne start? All acne starts with the hair follicle, and each follicle is made up of three components: a follicle shaft, the hair, and an oil-producing gland known as sebaceous gland. Sebaceous is S-E-B-A-C-E-O-U-S. Sebaceous gland is an organ in your skin that make and secrete sebum. Now, sebum is the oily substance that is made up of fat molecules called lipids. That includes cholesterol, glyceride, fatty acids, squalene, wax. That provides a protective coating for your skin to help retain moisture. So most sebaceous glands connect to your hair follicles in the second layer of your skin, which is known as the dermis. And the top layer, what we see, is the epidermis. So we have thousands of sebaceous glands all over our body. And the only place that we don't have sebaceous glands is on the palm of our hands and the soles of our feet. And we have the most sebaceous glands on our face and scalp. Now, sebaceous glands, there aren't attached. The sebaceous glands that aren't attached to your hair follicles are common in your private areas, lips, or inside of our noses. Sebum is a natural lubrication that protects our skin from things that rub up against our skin that can cause damage or some type of friction, moisture loss or brittle hair, infections caused by bacteria or fungi. And sebum also contributes to, you know, our body odor. Now, there are two types of sebaceous glands. The first one, the sebaceous glands that attach to your hair follicles. The second ones are the ones that aren't attached to your hair follicles. So there are some sebaceous glands that work, you know, with your sweat glands and opens at the surface of your skin instead of at your hair follicles. So both perform the same function, which is to create and release sebum. Now, the skin cells that line the follicle shaft are replaced by new ones every 28 days. So in acne, the cells lining the follicle wall produce too much keratin. This excess of keratin caused the dead skin cells to stick together, making them harder to expel. Now, I can't pronounce this word, so I'm going to let me try it.
Keratinocytes,
okay? Keratinocytes. Keratinocytes is an epidermal skin cell which produces keratin. Keratin is a protein that helps form your hair, your nails, and other skin's layer, you know, the epidermis. So keratin helps support your skin, helps with the, you know, heal wounds and keep your nails and your hair healthy. And there are 54 kinds of keratin in our body. Now, cells that are not expelled, mixed with the flow of oil that is produced by the sebaceous gland and can form a blockage in the hair follicle. So this plug of cells and oil is how most acne begins. Sometimes the blockage can come from outside of the hair follicle when substances like, you know, say for instance, like makeup, sweat, and oil on the skin's surface enters into the follicle's opening and it becomes trapped. Now, these blockages are called microcomedones, and they are too small to be seen with the eye. Now, you may be asking, what are comedones? So let's get into that. Comedones are skin-colored small bumps, which are called papules, frequently found on the forehead, the chin of those with acne. Now, a single lesion is called a comedone, as I said earlier. So now, blackheads are also known as what I say earlier. Do you remember? Right. Open comedones. Now, blackheads, there are small bumps on the skin that result from clogged hair follicles. They have a dark black surface that have become oxidized. So remember the blackheads. So oxygen in the air will react with the pigment in the oil, causing the blockage to turn a dark color. Now the color doesn't mean that it's dirt. It doesn't mean that. So basically, if the skin over the bump opens, if it opens, the air exposure causes the plug to look black and then forming the black head. So let me ask you something. How many of you that are watching this video, how many of you thought that when you saw people with black heads on the skin, you thought it was caused by dirt? I did. I used to think that they was dirty, but until I learned that that is not the case at all. It's just a built up sebum and dead skin cells trapped in the follicle and exposed to air. So if the skin does not open, then it's a whitehead forms. So blackheads are a mild form of acne and forms on the nose or the chin, but they also can appear on the back, chest, neck, arms, and on the shoulders. So blackheads, they are treated with a spot treatment that contains salicylic acid or benzoyl peroxide. Now, salicylic acid cleans out the pores. Okay, remember that. Salicylic acid cleans out the pores and benzoyl peroxide kills the bacteria. This is the way I have learned it. So the safest course of action is to remove the blackheads is to consider a treatment regimen. So, you know, first thing, keep your hands off your face and just allow your skin to heal. But if you're determined to have your blackheads extracted, then you estheticians out there who are new to facial treatments, use a cotton or aesthetic wipe and you wrap them around your finger, your index fingers, and add a little pressure on each side, you know, to remove the blackhead. So what you want to do is push up carefully and do like a rocking, you know, motion, a massaging motion. And doing this with sebum will, I mean, not with sebum, with steam, will help loosen and soften the plug. That's why we like to use the steam to help loosen it up so it can help with extractions. And enzymes is good for that too, to help loosen it. So when you get ready to extract, it won't be that much work. So what causes blackheads? Blackheads are a type of acne vulgaris or hormonal acne. Blackheads form when a hair follicle in the skin becomes clogged or plugged. So when oil, dead skin cells, and other debris continue to add a blockage in a hair follicle opening, then the blockage will grow and become visible. In plain terms, this oil gland is in overproduction, which happened during hormonal shifts like puberty, menstruation, pregnancy. Blackheads can also form when hair follicles are irritated or when dead skin cells do not shed regularly. So when there is an overproduction of sebum, oil, irritation of the skin, or an excess of dead skin cells, which contribute to clogged pores, hormonal changes such as puberty, medications, which are known to contributing to acne, stress is a big one that can trigger to acne and it cause a flare-up. So blackheads are not pimples. Pimples are small. Pimples are painful, discolored bumps with a thick white-yellow fluid. We call it like pus at the tip. Blackheads typically affect teenagers and young adults who are undergoing hormonal changes. And many adults continue to have acne in their 20s, 30s, and beyond. And some adult develop blackheads for the first time as adults. Whiteheads. Whiteheads are a type of acne vulgaris. That's a closed comedone. And they primarily remained under the skin, but produced a raised white bump. And y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all see it, okay? And it forms when dead skin cells, oil, and bacteria become trapped within one of your pores. Now, air isn't able to enter the follicle. So the bacteria inside don't undergo the same chemical reaction causes the blackheads to be dark. So blackheads and whiteheads are comedones. Blackheads are open bumps on the skin, and whiteheads are closed bumps on the skin. I hope you got that. Write that down. So, it always seems like to me the whiteheads develop at the worst times. You know, they just pop out of nowhere. You got an event and you got a whitehead. I just don't like them. Clogged pores are the main cause of whiteheads. So, you know, turn of events happen in all of our lives, you know, and at that stage in our life, we can increase the amount of sebum your pores will produce. So we could be going through so much stress, so many things, and just things just start to happen with our skin. So as you are listening, whiteheads and blackheads are classified as non-inflammatory acne, which means they are not infected. They're just clogged pores containing dead skin cells and natural oils called sebum that needs to come out of the skin. So I hope I explained that well to you. Enzyme is an exfoliation. And if you watch my other videos, you know I spoke about exfoliation. Exfoliation is very important to do. This is why exfoliation is very important, and it also can speed up the process of opening and unclogging the pores. Now, a deep cleansing enzyme peel can treat acne, rosacea, pigmentation issues while improving the fine lines and wrinkles by exfoliating the top layers of dead skin cells to expedite cell turnover. I like to use papaya, which is papain, and bromelain, which is pineapple enzyme, to remove those dead skin cells. The papain increases collagen production. Papaya has vitamin A, C, E, and antioxidants that help moisturize and nourishes and slow aging process. Bromelain improves skin texture by breaking down the proteins that causes the roughness and the unevenness in the skin. Bromelain is really good with reducing the pores and giving the skin more of a youthful appearance. Now, so you may be asking, who gets acne? What race gets acne? What age gets acne? Let me tell you. People of all races, of all ages get acne, but it's mostly common in teens and young adults. It's more common in males, but acne continues through adulthood. Then it's more common in women. Hormones may explain why acne is so common in teenagers. Now, during puberty, there's a hormone called androgen. Androgen, A-N-D-R-O-G-E-N. And that increases the size of the skin's oil glands, and these glands start to make more oil, which can clog pores. Now, even newborn babies develop a type of acne called neonatal acne, which usually appears between the second and fourth weeks of life. And this acne, it'll go away on its own. The babies won't have any scars. So I'm quite sure you heard of, you know, baby get like baby acne. One study found that smoking may play a role for some women with acne. Stress doesn't cause acne. Stress may worsen the existing acne, but it doesn't cause acne. Certain foods can worsen acne. Foods with high glycemic index, meaning the carbohydrates, cause a spike in blood sugar and insulin levels, which both contribute to acne formation. So this increases androgen and the 1 levels and prompts acne development. So these foods they're talking about are low in fiber, meaning works in effectively a slow digestion. Now, protein is a substance. Well, whey protein is a substance found in milk, and supplement form has been linked to increasing acne and has been demonstrated to overstimulate a hormone similar to insulin, like insulin-like growth factor -1. Now, this is in turn promotes sebum production, which is a main component of acne development. Sugar is referred to as a simple carbohydrate, like processed foods such as sweet desserts, processed fruit juices, sodas, candy, and syrup. Nuts are a healthy food for high protein but low carbohydrate profile, but some people with acne, some nut can worsen acne symptoms due to the presence of omega-6 fatty acids. So these acids are known to promote inflammation and include pine nuts, walnuts, and peanuts. I don't know if there are foods that can help get rid of acne, but foods that contain antioxidants like zinc contains anti-inflammatory, antibacterial properties. Zinc is found in whole grain breads, cereals, kidney beans, and I eat kidney beans only in my chili. peas, cashews, almonds, and oysters. Now, a diet rich, a diet rich in inflammation fighting would be the omega-3 fatty acids that can help prevent or reduce the severity of acne symptoms. So look for salmon, chia seeds, flax, tofu, or herring. That's another one. Or taking probiotics. That's another one. They're gaining traction too as for fighting acne, like as an acne fighting agent, the probiotics, to ward off toxins and bacteria and prevent acne breakouts. Probiotics are available. They are available in pill and powder form. But we all know that the Mediterranean diet goes a long way in improving your health and rebalancing your skin. Now, there are like four types of acne. You had the fungal acne. Fungal acne is when yeast builds up in your hair follicles, and that can be itchy and it can be very inflamed. The cystic acne, that causes deep pus-filled pimples and nodules, and they can cause scars. Hormonal acne, that affects adults who have an overproduction of sebum that closes their pores. The nodular acne, that is a severe form of acne that causes pimples on the surface of the skin. It can be really tender. The nodule lumps under the skin, really, really, really tender, really painful. So all of these forms of acne can affect one's self-esteem. Cystic and nodular acne can lead to permanent skin damage in the form of scarring. So with these, estheticians should not be treating these. I don't treat these. It is best to seek a healthcare provider early so they can determine what's the best treatment option for you. Symptoms of acne. Now, an acne pustule, P-U-S-T-U-L-E, acne pustule is a type of pimple, also known as a whitehead. And they are small growth on the surface of your skin. They become inflamed or discolored or having a white or yellow pus-filled tip. Basically, a pustule is a big pimple. That's how I can describe it. Pustules are tender to touch, and they sit beneath the skin and can occur anywhere on the body, so extractions will require some work. Some estheticians will leave them alone, and some will try to work it out. If extractions are done properly, they could potentially make things worse. So if you're pushing in the wrong direction when you're doing extractions, or you're pushing too aggressively, you could end up pushing the contents that's in that pustule. You could push those contents down into the skin, and that would trigger more inflammation and causing a bacterial infection. So you have to know what you're doing. You have to know how to extract. So some bumps need more time. So you just might want to wait to extract those, because, you know, everybody's skin is different. It's not a one size fit all. Everybody is different. So some, you know, pustules, you just have to wait on time. Let it develop a little bit more than you want to extract. A papule, P-A-P-U-L-E, that's a solid inflamed bumps on your skin that don't have a white or yellow pus filled tip. They appear as small discolored bumps, often red to purple or darker than your natural skin tone. Papules are not contagious. You can't spread them to another person through skin-to-skin contact. Papules can develop into pustules, though. Papules form when a comedone ruptures and the bacteria inside the comedone is released into the layers of the skin. So our body responds to these bacteria by becoming inflamed. Papules are often triggered by bacteria and excess oil production. There are some non-prescription medications that can help with cases of papules. Azelaic acid, that is a natural acid found in various grains of barley, wheat, rye. It kills microorganisms on your skin and reduces swelling. Azelaic, A-Z-E-L-A-I-C. Benzoyl peroxide, that targets surface bacteria, which often aggravate papules. It's a irritation, so it kind of, you know, the side effect of it is it causes dryness. So you have to be careful with the benzoyl peroxide because it does cause a little irritation as far as dryness. Retinoids. Retinoids is a vitamin A derivative. It breaks up papules. It helps prevent clogged pores. And you may notice a change in the skin color, like it's drying and peeling. So using a retinoid every other day or using it at the same time as a moisturizer can reduce these side effects. That's another one you need to be mindful of, is the retinoid. Salicylic acid, that helps remove the top layer of the damaged skin. So salicylic acid dissolves the dead skin cells to prevent your hair follicles from clogging. If you're on the organic side or you like to use home remedies such as myself, apple cider vinegar is a is another one. There is an acid in apple cider vinegar that kills off bacteria, so it's antibacterial. And if you have sensitive skin, apple cider vinegar can cause dryness and irritation. So it's good. It's a good idea to mix it with an equal amount of water. Apply like a small amount of mixture to a cotton ball or a cotton round, and rub it on your papules. Green tea is another good one, another organic remedy. So you can just take the wet leaves and from the tea bag. That's how I do. Open up the tea bag, get out the tea, and because it has an anti-inflammatory property and it can help reduce oil production in your skin. So you mix those dry green leaves with water and you massage the wet leaves on your papules in a small, circular motion for up to 30 seconds. Manuka honey, which is my favorite. Manuka honey, that contains an enzyme that's called catalase, C-A-T-A-L-A-S-E, which relieves minor inflammation. Lemon juice, that's another one of my favorites. You can't use a lot of lemon juice, but lemon juice is a citric acid in lemon juice, and that's an antibacterial. So you just apply a small amount of the lemon juice onto a cotton round or a cotton ball and rub it on your papula. Lemon juice may cause a little bit of stinging, but if you have sensitive skin, just be careful with that, especially when you're exposed to the sun. Tea tree oil, that can prevent or stop the growth of bacteria. So you apply a small amount of tea tree oil on a cotton round or cotton ball and rub it on your papula. Strawberries is rich in vitamin C. Strawberries have an anti-inflammatory property. It helps soothe and calm down breakouts. Strawberries contain salicylic acid. That's a BHA, beta hydroxy acid that cleanses your pores and keep bacteria away from it. So you can also try Skin Script Acne Kit. It has the raspberry cleanser and clarifying pads. It's really good recipe they put together for that. Nodule acne, that is very severe. And it's a deep form of inflammatory acne, where the clogged pore turns into a thick, firm, painful bump under the skin, which means the bumps is not communicating with the skin surface and it's impossible to extract. So this bump you can feel with your hand and it sits deep into the dermis layer of your skin, is very painful. So the reason why it's painful, because it sits close to your nerves. The nodule acne. And the nodules can last for several weeks. So this is something that should be treated by your dermatologist. I do not treat clients with nodule acne. The bacteria that naturally live on the skin is called C. acne. I cannot pronounce the name. It's C-U-T-I-B-A-C-T-E-R-I-U-M. And it becomes trapped under the skin in these nodules, so leading to an infection and inflammation. And if these are not treated, it will lead to permanent scarring. And it is said that nodule acne is more common in young people, primarily males. I just learned that, so I didn't know that. So you may be asking, where on your body can you get acne? The most common places that you might have your acne would be on your face, your forehead, your chest, your shoulders, and your upper back. So oil glands exist all over your body. And the most common locations of acne are where oil glands exist the most. So wherever there is a high concentration of sebaceous glands, that is where you're going to find it on the body. Acne seems to have no boundaries at all. It just doesn't care where it shows up at. So my question is, what is acne trying to tell us? And if you have been with me long enough, I always say acne, your skin will tell us a story. Your skin tells a story. So do you think each area on your face where the breakout takes place is giving us an insight into what is the underlying cause? I sometimes I want to be a decoder. Like, I really want to decode the whole thing. Maybe I really need to become a decoder. But, you know, today, you know, we talked about hormones, diet, stress, and I'm starting to wonder, is there an issue with an internal organ that is triggering acne in a particular spot? I don't know. I just be thinking about stuff. I don't know. So let's do some quick zoning. Let's do some quick zoning. Now we're going to zone, you know, we're going to zone, do a zone of the forehead. So when there are pimples on the forehead, now that is often linked to the digestive system, meaning you have to be having a hard time breaking down certain foods that you are consuming. So this could be a wake-up call that you're overeating sugar or processed food. Forehead acne can also be flared up by stress or irregular sleep, so you may need to de-stress. You may need to get some sleep, drink some water with some lemon to help with the digestion. Let's zone in on the cheeks. So the cheeks are related to the respiratory system. So pimples can arise from friction, like rubbing up against your pillow, not washing your pillowcases, not washing off your makeup before you go to bed, not washing your makeup brushes, and not cleaning off your cell phone. That is another one. Clean off the cell phones all the time. Do it all the time, many times as you want to in a day. Okay, let's zone in on the chin. So the chin indicates hormones, menstruation, pregnancy, and these can cause chin acne. So these fluctuations result in inflammation, excessive oil production, clogged skin cells. And I feel like the only things to do with this is, is to exercise, to release any tension buildup, you know, to de-stress. Certain things that you may need to eat that will help, okay? Let's zone in on the nose. Our nose is connected to the heart and the lungs. And in this particular area, the pores are larger in our nose. Nose acne indicates stress, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, hot foods. So try cutting back on those spicy foods and all of the salt. Let's zone in on the brows. Acne around the brows is linked to the gallbladder and the liver. So pimples like to come out and play when there is an overindulgence of unhealthy foods, alcohol, or food allergies. So cut down on the sugar, cut down on the fatty foods, late night snacks, come on, and that junk food, and try to stick with healthier choices. Look, y'all, I'm trying to, so I'm not even going to lie, I'm not going to front. It's hard for me, especially those late night snacks before I go to bed. You know, but so I think this concludes our lesson on acne today. It's a lot of great information. My brain is hurting. I feel like my brain is about to explode trying to remember all of this information. So I hope you all took some good notes. It's always good to go back and refresh, because with the skin and the layers of skin, it's a lot to learn. It's a lot to remember, because it's not a one-size-fits-all type of treatment. And I want to thank you all today for watching my video. Thank you so much for stopping through. Click the like button. Please share my video. Please feel free to leave me a comment in the comment section. I look forward to seeing you all next week. Y'all be safe out there. God bless you all. See you next time.